Today I'm sharing another portion of the interviews I've been conducting with Rachel Virginia Hicks. She is 97 years old. She was born and raised in the Junaluska section of Cherokee County here in North Carolina, Western North Carolina, where I live. She is a treasure trove of information about days gone by, wonderful wisdom, wonderful Appalachian ways. She's just a joy to talk to. If you missed any of the previous things I've shared, interviews that I've shared with Rachel, please look in the description below for a playlist. In the video today, she's really talking about foodways of Appalachia, shares a heartwarming story about the first blackberry pie that she ever made. She said she thought she was 11 or 12 years old. When I would go to visit with Rachel, I would always turn the camera on, even when we were setting up or when we were finishing up, because I didn't want to miss anything that she said. So you can kind of tell the blackberry stories kind of when I'm just setting everything up, got to get the lights, got to get the camera set up. So you can kind of tell that's what was going on. But I'm so glad that I captured that wonderful memory that she shared. In the video, later in the video, she talks about other Appalachian foodways, some of the favorite things that she really enjoys eating, some of the things that they used to grow in the mountains of Appalachia when she was a girl. So I hope that you really enjoy the video, and please be sure to check out that playlist, because every video that I've done with her is just a treasure.
If you, that's what you had. You didn't have electricity.
Right, yeah.
Yeah.
And you picked the blackberries and then made
and,
them?
Mama had, she canned blackberries. We'd get out when the blackberries got ripe and out in the fields where the cows been. They kept the rest of it, kept down in them blackberry bars to grow up, you know. And we'd go pick blackberries and can them. Mm-hmm. And Mom and Daddy was out of cutting some wood that day. It was cold, and they're getting some wood in. I thought, I must have been 11 or 12 years old, some somewhere. Mm-hmm. But, and I had my brothers, I was the oldest, so I had two brothers, I think, then. And I thought, I'm going to make a blackberry pie for dinner. So I went and built on the wood cook stove, and made the blackberry pie, and it wasn't long till Mama come in, and I'd got the pie done and set it out. And Daddy came in then, and they sat down and ate the blackberry pie. Daddy just bragged on my blackberry pie.
That's
the first thing I ever cooked.
Oh.
I'd watch Mama when she was cooking.
Yeah.
I'd make biscuits and things.
I love blackberries.
Mm. I do too. That's my favorite jelly is blackberry jelly.
Oh, I love it too. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. We almost had some good jelly this year too.
Yeah, I need to make some more jelly too. We're about out. But the grandkids love the strawberry freezer jam.
Mm-hmm.
Every time I have biscuits, they have to have strawberry freezer jam.
That's good.
Do you like to plant garden?
I do, yeah. We have a garden every year.
I love gardens.
Yeah. Love to grow garden. When I was young, I complained about it a lot, but then once I was grown, I wanted to do it too.
Yeah.
It's so
and can. I love to can.
I like to can, mm-hmm. Yeah. I like to can. It so makes you feel so good to pull out a jar of tomatoes or green beans that you grew and canned and then feed it to your family.
And kraut.
Yeah, I love to make kraut. Yeah.
Soups. You can take, a little, some potatoes, onions, mm-hmm. and a few carrots or whatever you got. And if you've got some kind of, lots of them, try to kill a hog, you know, they have hog meat.
Yeah.
Cook some meat and that, make a big pot of soup and a cake of cornbread. Mm. What else could you ask for?
Yeah, that's a feast.
Mm.
That's a feast, yeah.
Some slaw. I like slaw with mine.
Yeah, I like
slaw with my pinto beans.
Mm-hmm. I do too.
Like Kale, my grandson. He loves his slaw.
Yeah, I like slaw.
I like when I get a hot dog and put on a bun.
Mm-hmm.
I like to put slaw on my mm-hmm. hot dog.
I do too. That's what I had for supper last night. Hot dogs, I had made slaw to put on them. Yeah.
I do.
Mm-hmm.
It's amazing what you can do. You know, you can make slaw out of cabbage.
this sale.
And you can cook your cabbage.
Yeah, I love fried cabbage, boiled cabbage. I like to eat it raw. I just eat, chop it up and eat it raw.
Yeah, I like to make potato patties. I love it.
I've not tried that. That sounds good.
Oh, yeah, potato patties. And bean, pinto beans, where you cook pinto beans. You got some left over, mash them up and make some bean patties. They're good, too.
No, I've not tried that either.
Yeah, they are. Bean patties. Our potato patties, yeah. Kids love them.
Yeah, I love them. I can't never get mine to taste like my mama's, though.
Did you ever eat parsnips?
Not much.
Some people don't like parsnips, but I like parsnips. Yeah. And my daddy did.
Did you grow them in the garden? Did he grow them?
We didn't, but Aunt Zori White, we lived up at Hooper Place, and Will White lived right down below us. Will took over Hooper's job when Mr. Hooper got killed. I'd always known him ever since I was a little girl anyhow. And she always had a patch of parsnips. And after we moved from up there down to Bolden Branch, Daddy said, "Sis, one Sunday," he said, "would you like to walk? I go up to Aunt Zori's," everybody called her Aunt Zori, "and spend the night and get us some parsnips." So I did. I walked from there up there that Sunday evening and spent the night with Aunt Zori and Will now. And Arnold, they had their two youngest children, were twins, Arvel and Arnold. That's twins, that's my age. Me and Arnold went out and he got a hoe and he dug me some parsnips and I brought them home. My mama would cook them for us, but she didn't like parsnips. But I did, and Daddy did. And then she'd make us patties out of them. I liked them.
Yeah.
Lord, I ain't had no parsnips in years. Mama didn't care for them, but me and Dad liked them.
Mama talks about her aunt. One of her aunts would make parsnip bread. She would make bread out of it.
They're good to cook them just like junior potatoes, and mash them up, make patties out of them.
I like stewed turnips. I like my turnips like that.
Now, I've never mashed them, and I've never made patties out of turnips.
I bet they'd be good, too, probably. I don't know.
I never have. But, I like parsnip made patties. And beans, one time, Daddy's sister Corey made Arthur Green, and Arthur lived down at Andrews, right up above the Wachovia Bank it used to be, and he died, and I went and stayed with Daddy's sister Corey and her children down at town where they lived there. And Toby, that was a cousin, that was Daddy's sister, Gertie's daughter. She was my age, but Aunt Gertie died when we were just little girls. And Grandma and Grandpa was raising her, but she goes to St. Corey, too, with her kids. So we got up the next morning, and she had, let's see, there's Verdale and Glenn, and there's about four or five of them children. One of the boys, Harold, he's older than we were. But me and Toby got in our fixing breakfast, and there's a pot of beans sitting there. So I said, "Let's make some bean patties." So I'd never done it before, but I did. But me and Toby made bean patties, and then boy and Clint, he was old enough to get married, but he had never got married. He finally married my first cousin. Their mother had died, and Arthur had remarried and had married Daddy's sister then, and had these other children. But we got them bean patties cooked, and I don't remember what else we cooked. Everything we could find, we cooked it, I think. But they got in there, they like them bean patties. So
in Peekstore.
I'll have to try that. I've never had them.